You know a Freddie Calhoun?
Sure, I know Freddie.
Freddie needs money to get out of town. Says he's prepared to blow the whistle on a Primo reefer distribution ring. Says he
can. Has he said how much it's going to cost?
$50.
And the department will front me the $50?
You can put in an expense claim. He's over at Mike Lyman's on Hollywood Boulevard. See what you can find out.
The thing was, he was a real nice guy. I felt lousy.
$50. Did I think I'm made of money?
No, you just look like you're made of money.
Oh, very good. The kid's on form. I'd say on a scale of dull to scintillating, you're a solid tedious today, which you can be pleased with.
Do you ever listen to yourself?
I don't have the same voices in my head as you, Nicole. I don't care. I don't go in for letting gangsters off scot-free.
He says, dig, dig, the jump's the old ticker is given. He can talk plainer than that. He says, murder, he says.
Get this. Middle of the afternoon, this crazy woman decides to set fire to the hotel she lives in. The fire brigade coming.
Goddamn maniac!
Get this. Middle of the afternoon, this crazy woman.
You're paying for every last scratch.
Get this. Middle of the afternoon, this crazy woman decides to set fire to the hotel she lives in.
That cherry pie was delicious.
There's a little sneak. That's him in the back, Cole. Freddy. You're looking good.
You're gonna help me, right?
That's what I'm here for.
You got the money?
The 20? Sure, right here.
20? I said...
You want the money or the alternative? Tell us about the reefer, Freddy.
Who's he?
Another good Samaritan. Answer the question.
West comes from Tijuana. They bring in 50 pounds a week.
50 pounds? Are you hallucinating, Freddy?
Gets stashed at a house at 1452 North Las Palmas.
Names, Freddy.
The guy at the house is a spick that goes by the name Juan Garcia Cruz. And be careful. He likes guns. How do I get my money?
Do me a favor, Freddy. Spend the money on a bus ticket. You can't last forever on a snitch jacket. Let's go visit this Cruz character. Believe a story? Sure. A hophead like Freddy would raffle his sister for his next score.
Son of a bitch!
Thank you.
help at 1452 North Los Angeles. Shots fired. You just stay and identify code 3.
Throw out the guns.
Next time I won't be so nice.
You guys don't half leave a mess. What happened?
Dope peddler, Juan Cruz. He opened fire and, well, the rest of the story tells itself.
Dollar. I thought they took these things out of circulation.
Juan Garcia Cruz. This is his address, but this place looks like a front. Drug or village in Borneo. Doesn't appear to be in Spanish.
Doesn't anyone eat regular meals anymore? Junkies feeding on popcorn and grasshoppers living on soup.
Keeping one so well stocked with soup. Now we're getting somewhere.
Seems irrelevant.
Ha! Phelps, you jump like a girl.
More soup? Who in the hell keeps a secret stash of soup?
You hungry or something, Phelps?
I'd say that's pretty good value for 12 cents.
Factory sealed. Someone at the cannery has a lot of explaining to do.
With Juan dead, we need a new suspect, Cole. Is there a pattern to the deliveries?
This guy, EJ, seems to be bringing in most of the serious weight. The dates and times seem pretty regular. We should notify the border crossing.
Those fuckers are probably in on it. Let's wait and see how this plays out.
through. I just want a quick look is all.
Brother says the morphine is still turning up.
Makes sense. We have no idea how much of the stuff Lenny shifted. There's been no comeback from Cohen as yet.
Maybe Confidential Magazine is right, and Bugsy is on the slide.
You read that stuff? I wouldn't say it to his face if I was you. That is one hot-tempered son of a bitch. Christ alive, this is a nightmare!
LAPD. Who owns this factory, ma'am?
Mr. Parnell. Howard Parnell. I'll let him know you're here. Please, take a seat.
If you don't mind, we'll come with you.
If you must.
You just wanted a follower, didn't you? You sly dog. I must apologize for my partner's roving eye. He hates saying goodbye, but he loves watching them leave.
Give it a rest, Roy.
If you could show these men in to see Mr. Parnell, Doris. They're from the LAPD.
Follow me, gentlemen.
What is going on?
LAPD, sit tight, fatso. You could be in very serious trouble.
There's no reason to be rude. Take a seat, gentlemen. I'm sure we can sort this all out.
Maybe you can explain why we found $5 bags of marijuana in sealed Parnell soup cans.
That's an outrageous allegation.
How do you explain it, Chubby? We found at least 30 cans, all sealed up tight with your label on it.
Can I get a list of your employees?
Of course. We have nothing to hide. Doris, can you bring me in the current employee listing?
Here it is, Mr. Parnell.
On the desk, please.
Any name on that list that rings a bell?
This is familiar. 1452 North Las Palmas. A Jorge Garcia Cruz.
The factory sealed cans we found suggest a very professional operation, Mr. Parnell. We're looking for an inside man.
I know nothing about this. I want this stopped as much as you do.
Tell me what I want to know, Parnell, or I will have half the LAPD down here tearing this place apart. You're hiding something.
Am I right in thinking you would not want to pursue misdemeanors outside your drug case?
Depending on what you call a misdemeanor, we might be prepared to turn a blind eye.
The truth is, I employ a lot of illegals. No one wants to do menial work anymore. Most of my factory staff are wetbacks. The local blacks and Chicanos all want jobs in aircraft factories.
Presumably because the pay is a lot better. How are your sales, Mr. Parnell?
Just fine and dandy, son. We're entering a new era of prosperity. I hope you're both big soup eaters.
Mr. Parnell, do you know what kind of trouble you're in? Come clean with us.
Okay, so things are a little flat. We're deciding whether to lower production. It's taken a while to adjust to not having any military contracts. You know, we sold Uncle Sam 5 million cans of minestrone.
Ever heard of Juan Garcia Cruz?
Not that I know of.
He has a brother employed here. You know him?
We employ large numbers of Mexicans. I'm not familiar with them all.
That's funny, Parnell. He has the same address as his brother Juan, who we shot dead less than an hour ago. You better give me something.
Look, I'm not involved in this. I'm getting enough grief from Washington. There's an investigation going on into profiteering. Like a guy shouldn't be able to turn a buck while the war is on.
I'm sure thousands of dead Marines sleep soundly knowing that you did okay. Tell us about Jorge Garcia Cruz.
Jorge? I had no idea of his last name. His team does daily maintenance on the conveyor belts and cookers.
So he's here now?
No, maintenance is at night. Night shift finishes around midnight. He would usually come in around 9 p.m. and have everything ready for the morning shift at 6.
We'd like to take a look around the factory floor, Mr. Parnell.
I hope we won't have to shut down the line.
No, nothing like that.
Thank you. I'm grateful for that. I'll show you around myself.